And if you don't have any of these, as I said, you can check the website. It's still really good. It basically works as easy as clicking one button, and you get all the most insane clips from recent broadcasts, from past moments. It's always a pleasure to check all of these clips just at the grasp of your finger.
Yeah, and I know we're still talking about MetaView as the match has started and Venice taking 42%, and that's important. But if you're like me or Cirque, who's always like trying to learn commentary, one thing that I do like about MetaView being it's a beautiful app icon. I'm really particular about that because I really hate bad app icons, but MetaView's icon is really, really pretty. And I love the colors. And GGG coincidentally has about the same colors as the MetaView icon. That being aside, if you're trying to study a matchup, just look up those clips, man. And sometimes just studying a little clip here and there, even for a moment a day, like 5 minutes, and watching that clip on MetaView, that can help you out so much in the long run because you'll remember that clip and you'll remember how things happen. So definitely give yourself some time, man, just to download the app and study a few clips. You'll learn a thing or two even while you're on the go. But let's get back into this match, as literally both our players are just separated by 1% and one neutral exchange, because you know that Ven and you really want to sit pretty on grand finals, especially for Ven. I think with all the players and all the characters Ven has gone through, this is Ven's opportunity to win grand finals. But you also has a lot to say about that.
Yeah, they've been shown insane skill and adaptation in previous matches, both of them actually. And in this winner's final match, remember, just to give you some context, both of these are still on the winner's side of bracket, and they deserve it because they've been playing insanely well. We've seen use Mega Man earlier. It's just the scoreboard is inverted, I think.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and we've seen Ven earlier just how well it worked on against his opponent, how good he performed every single motion. I think this is the perfect match to see in winners finals because of how well these competitors adapt, how aggressive and methodical they can be with their respective characters.
Yeah, that'd be great for you to still have that DI. Mega Man is a little bit of a heavy robot, but he does stuff. He's deceptively heavy, but not as heavy as you want him to be. He's still kind of light. The one thing for you, though, was to be just able to hold that proper DI and then roll and get away from Zelda's up smash. That's one thing. And also, we talked about this quite a few times. Characters like hitboxes and hurtboxes are much more prominent, very similar to how tech it is in Tekken, because Namco and Bandai did play a hand in creating this game. So the fact that Mega Man was short enough to actually avoid that up smash was really big. Great DI from you, but also the ability to use directional air dodge right away to just avoid being in the blast zone and then move yourself as early as possible, because Mega Man doesn't have the best recovery when it comes to being far off on the sides. But unfortunately, though, Ven will get that stock. And then 95, you take some time on the Angel platform to bypass the Zelda setups.
You know, I was gonna argue with that on that topic of Mega Man's recovery, but you're absolutely correct. Mega Man does sport a very high recovery, but his horizontal reach is not the best. You're 100% correct. And right now, we're still on the last stock with even percentages. As I mentioned earlier, it's ridiculous the amount of adaptability that these competitors have. Every single time they trade, it's back and forth. Nobody gets a sizable lead, at least in this first game. We know that the most explosive situations are when they get to download their opponent's patterns, but right now they just have to go with their neutral, and it's really good overall. All of the pieces are slowly connecting together, and it's just a matter of time before they learn how to punish his opponent's both aggression and defensive options.
Yeah. And it's hard too, because we can sit here and talk about how like being able to do that in practice is good. But the reality is the execution while you're getting hit by your opponent, it's hard. But what a good oh my god.
I love Shoryuken, dude. I love Mega Man Shoryuken. It's just so cute. Like he learned the best. He saw Ryu and hey, I want that. I want that move and I'm gonna master it. And he might not be as strong as maybe Ken Masters, but it's really good when you get those high percentages and with a sweet spot to deal lethal damage. Mega Man taking one stock was one of my favorite moves.
I think that's what Yu has been doing really good as being able to punish his opponent's rolls. We kind of saw that up against Javier, specifically just because, like, all right, cool, I can punish those rolls. But not only that, that setup, Leaf Blade forces that close range encounter between you and your opponent at that ledge, that if you distance yourself the way that you had, oh man, you can get so much off of it. And it goes to show that up tilt was coming out to play, and it was definitely not missing it. So good on you. For those of you guys wondering, how did Mega Man get that Shoryuken? Mega Man actually had his own fighting game back in the day. It was called Mega Man the Power Fighters, I think was what it was called. And it was like a rare like arcade cabinet game. And like the only game that Mega Man actually gets that Shoryuken, by the way. And Mega Man does get like a Hadouken in his own game, Mega Man X. But we can talk about that some other time, because it is going to be you and Ven back at it again here with you with game one in his hands. It's going to be on Ven to see if I can come back here as you is just continues that same relentless arsenal that he had against his opponents onto Ven.
Yeah, listen, Vance, I know I can speak for everyone here. I'm not the only one who loves those little trivia tips and secrets, so thank you. We appreciate that. It's always nice to know a little bit of background on characters, but definitely the task at hand is that these competitors are doing a phenomenal job of roll. You trying to read that recovery. It was either a fake out trying to hit with Farore or a recovery to the ledge, and you was ready with that downer. He wants to get the spike one more time. You know he's always fishing for those. Great pressure from Ven, both with Din's fire and the Phantom. He's trying to force a situation where you mixes up or messes up his recovery in order to catch him. But right now, both of them doing a phenomenal job at avoiding each of their opponent's pressure, both on the ledge and within the stage.
Yeah, and honestly, that was good for Ven to go for a higher Fowler's win, just to be able to kind of call out specific location where Yu was at. Even if Yu does miss that down air, the one thing that's good for it is that your opponent will take a mental note out of it, and it'll force them to really think about rolls. Big problem here is that Ven is a player that will always try to adapt to you, and he'll punish you for that habit. So Ven is not going to let that slip by every single time here. So good on Ven to capitalize on that one here for Yu. It is trying to get this stuck off Ven. Finally understanding, you know what, I'm this close to Ven. Let me get this forward air, and then let me see that stock finally go away.
Yeah, he's doing a lot of, he's using his Parore's wind really well overall, not only for recovering, but also for pressure at all times. And the crash bomb is not only a tool that allows your opponent to have like a little bit of shield pressure, but also try to condition certain actions, either an air dodge or something, reflecting that up air really, really well execution. I love how Ven uses Zelda's, the goddess, the gifts from the goddesses at all times. He's really effective. It really shows how well Ven knows his character, and a character that is definitely not top tier or anywhere near high tier at that. But it's really nice to see how it performs under such skillful hands overall.
Okay, so far Yu looking to come back on towards their stage here. Nearly missing the mark. And unfortunately, that Nehru's love has lasted so long that it was actually able to stop that. Back air here from the ledge jump. You narrowly miss. See, that's good. He's still able to hit that, but the problem is Ven is still living here at 103. But it's good just to get Ven off the stage. Sets up for that crash bomber. You can just tell right now, Yu is looking for all the opportunities to not have Ven have any lead for as long as possible.
No, but Ven doing a phenomenal job at avoiding all of these interactions where he should be at a disadvantage. Instead, taking and turning it around at all times, trying to capitalize. And again, that back air barely not getting the right DI, at the last moment. Even though he was really close to getting it, the percentage and the knockback that such a move has is just ridiculous. Zelda with the back air, Zelda with the forward air is going to take your stock if you're not either prepared or if there's no other thing you can do. Like, if the percentage is high enough, you can basically take your stock gone with that. It's really effective at taking stocks, and Ven knows this, so he's been very accurate when it comes to landing these aerials, which are devastating overall.
The funny thing about forward air, back air, and even neutral air is they're deceptively fast. They're not as slow as you think they would be. Like, forward air, back air, and neutral air are just it's they're like frame six, if I'm not mistaken. So like that's fast. Basically, that's what it is. It is fast. Most players would expect the knockback on a move like that to be slow, but no, man, Zelda just whips out the Prada sandals right in your face, and you are losing stocks and you are flying, and it's crazy. The thing about it though is that it does have a specific sweet spot that you have to hit.
Yeah, that's the thing.
And for Ven, he's such a master at it, so it's okay.
Yeah, you have to be accurate with Zelda, which is why a lot of people don't either maintain the character or practice a lot with it. However, those who persevere and stick to the character definitely see results just such as these. Ven doing a phenomenal job in this run so far. He's taken you to the game number 3 in a situation where where Battlefield is going to allow Ven with his Phantom to play around and put you in such positions such as these unescapable situations where he has to move, but there's no way around to run. And just like that, taking a beautiful first stock with only 43% to his name. It's just ridiculous the way that Ven uses every single bit of his tools to deal devastating damage every single time.
Yeah, man, that was a very good example of how I said, like, Zelda's Knight is a Marvel 3 assist, because that was looking like a Marvel 3 assist happening right there with that setup into that forward air Ven, just putting out all the stops. This is a stage that I argue to anybody. When you're playing against the Ven matchup, you don't take Ven here. There's just too much he has going on here with Knight, but finally you will have a little bit of a break here, 59% on him, up to on Ven, not enough pressure, but Ven rolls, gets caught by this down throw back air, still able to get out here and then put out the neighbor's love, because if you had any projectiles, so to speak, he will not have to worry about it, and Ven once again looks for control. This is what you don't give Ven the stage. The Knight's sword swing goes through the bottom portion of the stage, but also hits the platform, but if Ven so chooses to space you out perfectly, which you can do literally anytime, you will get hit even on the platform.
Yeah, Battlefield is ridiculous. Yeah, exactly, as you said it. Battlefield is ridiculous for Zelda, because she can... What? That was... I don't know if that was insane SDI or what, but he basically escaped that up smash and punished with Nehru's love. Frame one, basically. Insanely quick reaction time from Ven, but this is exactly what happens. If you leave Zelda to place the Phantom wherever she wants, she could get a lot of mileage from. Either, as you mentioned, the two frame, or maybe just to condition a jump or anything to punish every single interaction. Zelda is going to take advantage of these tri-platforms to deal as much damage and to set up as hard as possible in order to get a stock insanely early. And right now it's showing. However, you still, even though he has a lot of percentage, he might be able to take the stock if he gets the right read right here.
Yeah, we saw this against his previous opponent. You just had to put on the batteries and it was pretty much over. But we'll see. I mean, Ven is one of those players that forces you to play his game a lot. And he's also one at controlling, really strong at controlling the tempo. That can be hard to steal it back. But he's also good at escaping your tempo. I think that's what makes Ven really difficult. That's why he was one of those few players that got really close to beating MKLeo offline. And that's what makes Ven so strong with the character and his mindset altogether. So just... honestly, that's what makes him really good. So 142, finally a lucky break here for you, but it hopefully is not too little too late. You can just see the percent on Mega Man. Honestly, one setup from Ven, one forward smash, anything at this point will be game three in Ven's hands.
Yeah, it's still doable, but it's going to be insanely hard because of how Ven has been showcasing the ability to place and to set up every single time that he gets a chance. Getting the Farore, I thought it was going to be the spike. I was actually scared because that down air from Yu's Mega Man was on point. He could have gotten the spike, but instead got hit with that devastating blow from the goddess of wind herself, Farore, dealing the damage that needed in order to get a secure game number 3 in Ven's favor. Beautifully done from the Cell Domain.
Yeah. I guess looking at chat here really quick, and chat ever wondering. It just depends on where you live in the States about offline. I'm not a scholar, or I'm not anybody who's highly intelligent when it comes to that kind of stuff. But I will say that demographics plays a factor into being vaccinated, but also how that, if you theoretically live in a city, anything like the common cold can spread fast because there are so many people closely huddled to each other. But if you live in rural parts of the United States, then yeah, you don't have to worry about the common cold. So if you think about that for something like COVID, then yeah, if you live in a more rural place, you don't have to worry about things like that. But it all depends, man. In some rural areas, they could probably more afford to have offline. But if since 2G gaming is located in a city that is Los Angeles, we have to operate in such a procedure that it will take us some time to come back to offline. Even though Infinity Con happened and there was a lot of safety things going on, which I'm happy to hear and happy to see, it doesn't play the same for everywhere else. You know, we are coincidentally one of the big cities, and we have to treat that safety as one of our number one concerns because we live in one of the big cities.
Yo, speaking about big cities, I miss Los Angeles. It's been such a long time since I've been there. You guys better take me there. I want to commentate in one of the offline MSMs eventually.
We would love to have you, man. We will. And the best part about MSM on offline is that it's actually located in a hotel. So if you still have to choose to stay the night, oh man, you are all set.
Yeah, but that's still a long time to go because, as you mentioned, we have to remain vigilant. We have to remain safe at all times. And you can't put it on TOs to risk people. We all have to focus. And just like that, we need to focus on this game that we have so far because just like that, Yu has a lead right now. And even though it's not big because he's really close, he's taking the most advantage of these side platforms that Town and City provides. However, then taking advantage of that up air with an insane hitbox that it has, not allowing him to recover safely. And even though the percentage is looking a lot on Yu's favor, it's still very doable because we've seen Ven take advantage of every single interaction whenever he gets an opportunity.
Yeah. The funny thing about, just to close out that tangent for me, I guess, the funny thing about Wi-Fi and the funny thing about COVID is the characters that do the best are the characters that unironically social distance. So that being Mega Man and Zelda just being in a funny sense like social distance, and I know it's a corny joke at this point, it just goes to show like what you can do with those characters. But the one thing about Ven as a player is that he's also aggressive. He doesn't look to just play passive and patient. He will be aggressive, and you can see how that aggressiveness can be turned on with the flip of a switch as he gets that Fowler's wind kill.
Yeah, for sure. It's very important that we realize and we understand that even though, oh, dude, I was going to say that Ven had a lead, but it's not like that's not the case anymore. Now it's Yu who's slowly trying to bring it back. However, Ven is not letting him at all times. He keeps that Nair's love. He keeps the Phantom at all times. And he keeps the aggression. The percentage is climbing very dangerously. However, we know that Mega Man needs only one string to deal a lot of damage. So Ven with his Zelda needs to be very careful if he wants to take this set, because Yu is no slouch. As soon as he gets a download, he is going to go in for the kill.
Yeah, so far Yu kind of playing patient like that. He waits out all the hits of Leaf Shield to try to get the most damage as possible in his next opportunity here. But unfortunately, oh man, that sword swing from that is so wide. You have to really account for that from every single getup. Even if you jump poorly at the wrong time, that will definitely set you back not only a game but a stock. But for you here, it literally means life or death. It literally means game four over or game five possibility. Dash attack, good DI here coming up from you, able to go for that low recovery as he sets up the crash bomber. Honestly, for Ven, the game plan remains the same, man. I have to slow the tempo down for you and not give him any opportunities.
Yeah, and it's very dual for both of them. They need to keep this clutch factor, this sense of danger at all times, a high alert. However, that dash attack is going to take the game and the set in Ven's favor. Yu goes to loser side, but he's not out of the tournament yet. Beautiful performance from both of them. Winners, I'm sorry, Ven advances to